God loves his Jewish people, and Jesus wept over them, and he wants the church to love the Jewish people as well, regardless of what you believe about the future for Israel. Jewish people need Jesus, and so I just want to see the church fulfill what Paul saw in Romans 11, that salvation has come to the Gentiles in order to provoke Israel to jealousy.
The Bible tells us to pray for the peace of Jerusalem, and let's follow that instruction. Let's pray for the peace of Jerusalem. We know that that peace is only going to come when the Prince of Peace comes back to Jerusalem. Let's pray that that the church in Israel would be strengthened, that it would be supported by the church abroad outside of Israel. Let's pray for churches all over the world to catch a vision for Jewish evangelism and for Jewish ministry, so that they could share the gospel and partner with others who share the gospel, so that Jewish people could be reached for Jesus.
Jewish evangelism is extremely important because it is part of the overall program of God to bring the cosmos together and to bring the peoples, the strange peoples that he has created together. If those who were originally his chosen people can be connected to the rest of the world, that is part of what shows the wholeness of what God's salvation is all about.
The continuation of the Jewish people is a clear signal that God has not forgotten his covenant, has not broken any of his word and promise. And it's more about his character, his faithfulness, his unyieldedness to anything that would change him, that we can count on him. We're not a perfect people any more than anybody else is a perfect people. So it's not about us, it was always about him. And I think the continuation of the Jewish people is a very clear signal that God is here. He's still at work, he still has a plan, and we can trust that while that salvation plan is unfolding to the nations.
We need to talk positively about the impact of the gospel, and that's not just a present day hope, but it's a future hope as well. So let's not rob the church of the future hope. Let's keep the Jewish people and God's plan for Israel as central to our understanding of history now and going forward. And that will be a certain impetus to Jewish evangelism in the church.
I think the church must more realize it today that sharing our faith is also creating an environment where it is where you can live out this faith, where you can discover this faith. And I think for Jewish people today also, it's also being invited into a community where this is where you are accepted, where there's a way of life that you live, and in that way you reach out to the Jewish community.
In God's sovereign plan, there are Jewish people and Israelis almost everywhere in the world. There is hardly to find a country or a large community that they are not Jewish people or Israelis. And I think that understanding a little bit that culture makes an open door when you meet somebody that is Jewish or Israeli.
My hope, my dream, my prayer is that in just the next decade, that 1%, 1.04% of Messianic Jews among the Jewish population would at least have doubled. That 2% is what we need to see real movement. That's the tipping point. If God will do that in the next 5 to 10 years, the rest will be done.
It's important to evangelize Jews because we're people too. We're an unreached people group. And certainly Jesus' heart was for Jewish people to know him. He wept over Jerusalem. And God's created us, if we have the message, to give the message away. If we want to see the world come to faith, then we need to include Jewish people in helping us to bring the gospel to the world.
If you look at the pattern of Paul in the book of Acts, you will see that the gospel, at least, should be given to the Jew first. Or if you can't do it, how about this? Don't allow Jewish evangelism to become the great omission of the great commission. So I subtitle it sometimes, to the Jew at least. But really, God wants us to make Jewish evangelism a priority of heart.
So it's a very difficult thing to shared the love of God with a nation that has been persecuted, even persecuted in the name of God, in the name of the cross. Jewish people have suffered tremendously. Yet, they got to see beyond that. And it's very difficult, but not impossible, because we have been given the power of the Holy Spirit. And with that, and love, and time, and commitment, and understanding, we can reach the Jewish people.
Don't accept the lie, first of all, that Jews don't need Jesus, because they do. Don't accept the lie that it's the job of Jews who believe in Jesus to witness, because Paul knew that wasn't the case and said, no, you guys are supposed to be one of the main reasons Jews are coming to believe in Jesus. And thirdly, please help us and let us help you fulfill the Great Commission when it comes to Jewish people, because they're not just in Israel speaking Hebrew. They're in your backyard. They're in your neighborhood. They're at your office, your school. And as Christians, let's partner together to see God's plan for his Jewish people in Jesus fulfilled.
Because the Jews are the apple of God's eye. The Jewish people have such a connection with God that we cannot neglect Jewish evangelism. And I think Jewish evangelism is not only helpful and good for the Jewish people, but for the church at large, because it shows the faithfulness of God.
I see so many millennials my age, Jewish and non-Jewish, who are who are desperately searching for some sort of meaning and truth and love, and like deep, true love. And I just really, really want people to understand that, you know, having a relationship with Jesus isn't at all a religious. It's spiritual, and it's life-giving, and it's fulfilling and satisfying. So I just want my Jewish brothers and sisters to understand the truth of who Jesus is and what life that he can bring to their hearts and to their lives.
Everybody who has a heart for Jewish evangelism has to find their place, and nobody has the corner on the market. All of us working together and praying and asking the Lord where we fit in this paradigm that he has established.
God's not finished with the Jewish people yet, so I'm hoping that God will use you and your local church and your family to reach Jewish people with the gospel, and then, boy, one day it's going to be great. Jewish people will repent, Jesus will come back in return, and we will be together around his throne worshiping the Jewish Messiah. Does it get any better than that?
Jewish people are messengers without a message, missionaries without a mission. That message is the message of the one true God and his son Jesus. And the mission is to share that message with the rest of the world.
The Holy Spirit came upon Jews in the Old Testament period and has come to live inside of us as the helper that Jesus promised to all those who would trust in his blood at the cross of Calvary. So it's the story is consistently there, and it's a transformative story, and it's hinged on loving God and knowing him in the way that he wants to be known and loved, and his gospel that culminates in the coming of the Messiah, Jesus.